video sponsored by Meeple Movers. No minimum order, no subscriptions. Free shipping on every item, every day. At MeepleMovers.com.
Hello and welcome to Brian's Got Game. I'm Brian.
And I'm Aiden. And today, I got a game called Bugs on Rugs.
Bugs on Rugs is a 2-5 player set collection game by Peter C. Hayward and published by Kids Table Board Gaming. In this game, players are collecting bugs. There are 9 different types. I can't do that. 9 different types, and each one scores differently, like 1 point per firefly for each rug color, and 5 points per ant if you have the most, 7 points per spider if you kill a fly, and so on. Each bug also has an action associated with it. They're triggered when it's the last bug on the rug at the end of the round. These actions are things like pass a bug to your left, pass a bug to your right, or switch a bug on one of the ones on the table. The game ends when the end card is revealed. The final card is passed out, then all the bugs are scored. So let's check it out, and I'll show you which bugs are best to collect,
what to do with the mosquito, and how to take advantage of a bug's action in Bugs on Rugs.
To set up, shuffle the deck, and then separate it into some piles. So the number of piles are going to depend on the number of players. In a 2-player game, you're going to put it in 3. In a 3-player game, it's going to be in 2 piles. 4 players, also 3 piles. And in 5, you're going to split it into 4. So we're going to be playing a 4-player game. So we split it into 2 piles, and then we put the end card where the yellow line is. So the more amount of players, the more cards you get to use. This is going to go 2/3 of the way through the deck. So let's stack these up. Then we're going to flip that over. Put those on top. Then we're going to, each player gets 1 card to be their starting hand. And then we flip over 1 card to be the wall. Then we randomly choose the start player. And then they are the start player. The start player then deals out the number of players plus 1. Number of players times 2 plus 1. 2x plus 1. Out on the table. So we have 4 players, so we multiply that by 2 is 8, plus 1 is 9. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 9. So this is the rug, and that's the wall. So then the start player looks at their hand, and then they're going to pick a card, and then that will be the first card in their hand. So we're going to pick that up. So this is a set collection game, and each bug scores differently. So I picked this one up. This one is, this is the beetle. If you have an even number of them, then you get 5 points for every beetle. If you have an odd number of them, then you get 2 points for every beetle. So you want even numbers of those. So I drew a beetle. This guy has something in his hand. He has a fly. So a fly is normally just 2 points. But if you have a spider along with the fly, you can kill the fly to get 7 points. So I'm going to take the spider. Here we have a mosquito. This guy also had a mosquito, if you wanted to know. This guy has a mosquito, and he's going to pick up this firefly. So the firefly is the number of fireflies you have multiplied by the different rug backgrounds. So if at the end of the game this was my hand, I would have 1, 2, 3, 4 different rounds, so I'd get 4 points if I only had this one. Well, 5 if you count this brown one. So I'd get 5 points for him. So I picked that up, and then this player has a fly, and we're going to pick up the ant. So the ant is, if you have the most ants, you get 5 points for every ant. If you are second, you get 3 points for every ant, and then everybody else gets 1 point for every ant. So then we keep picking up. So I picked up 1 card, and we're here. We're going to pick up the other beetle. Second action, and then this guy is going to pick up another fly. We're going to pick up a butterfly, and then this guy has those, and we're going to pick up this. So then we resolve the action of the last card left. So in a way, the last player gets to choose what action is out there. So this one is everybody passes a card to their right. So we're going to put that up on the wall. The last one goes up on the wall, and then everybody passes a card to their right. So you have to look at their hand, choose one to pass to the right. So you're going to place it face down, and they don't get to look at it until after they put them all down. So we're going to pass cards to everybody. We're going to pass that one. Mosquitoes aren't particularly awesome, but if you have 2 of them, then they can count as any bug card, which one of that bug, which can help if you need to kill a fly or a spider, or there are some other ones that I'll explain together. So everybody passed the card. So then the start player shifts, and then we deal out 9 cards again. And then we just keep going until we reach the end card. So we got 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Right. So here we have this. So I'm gonna pick up this ladybug. So ladybugs, if you have four of them, they're 25 points, which is a lot. And then if you don't have four, they're 1 point each. So it can kind of be a shoot the moon type action there. Here we've got that. So there's no spiders. We could go for ants. Where we could pick this guy up. Keep getting points for our rugs. Here there's an ant. Let's pick him up. And then there's more beetles. We'll pick that up. Look. His ladybug's still there. And then this guy doesn't want him to get his other beetle, plus it's another rug color. So let's pick that up. And then everybody else gets flies. And the last one is we're passing a card to the right again. So then everybody would pass. So there are some other actions on there. So as you see, the beetle is passed to the left. This ant is, you put it on the lineup and then you flip over the next card on top and then you do that action. The mosquito and some other ones are you swap, in turn order, everybody swaps a card from their hand with one of the ones on the wall. That can be a way to get those. The butterfly is the first player gets to look at their hand and pick an action from their hand. And the ladybug is you get to draw a card directly from the deck into your hand. So those are just some of the other actions. So play continues, dealing out 9 cards, drawing them, and then collecting your hand. You keep doing that until the end card comes up, which it should be around here. There. So when that comes up, when that's dealt out, you continue to deal 9 of the normal cards, and then you, you finish the round, and then you count up all the points using this handy-dandy rule score sheet. So first you score butterflies. It's in an order so you can resolve things. So first you assign all of your mosquitoes to where they need to be, and then you score butterflies. So butterflies are 1 point for every suit which you have 1 card in. So if I had a butterfly, I would get 1, 2, I get 2 points. Well, I put this over here, so I get 3. So I'd write 3 there. And then fireflies, I don't have any. They're 1 point for every rug per firefly. And then you just keep going down, scoring them. Ladybugs last. I only got 2 points from them. And then in the case of here, you'd score spiders before the flies. So that makes it so I wouldn't get the 2 points here. I kill the fly to get 7 points. So I'd write 7 there. So after you count up all the points, the player with the most points wins. That's how to play Bugs on Rugs.
Okay, I've got my dad and my sister here, and we're going to talk about Bugs on Rugs. So the components are cool. We've got cards. It's a card game.
Yes, but this is a preview copy.
This is.
So the components were not final.
Yes, and then they could add a couple things. I don't know. They could make the cards really nice. I don't know. There's not a whole lot there. So artwork. Aiden, you want to talk about the artwork?
They did a really good job on the artwork. I really enjoyed playing it because it was really fun, and they did a really nice job on the artwork.
Yeah, the bugs are super cute.
Yeah.
Every time I played it, there was always somebody standing, a bystander,
mm-hmm.
asking, you know, what's that game? How's Bugs on Rugs? And I think it's the art that kind of draws people in.
Yeah. So strategy. You've got your hand of cards, and then you're looking at them and trying to pick the best card for you. So if you're dealt a ladybug or two at the beginning, it might be good to go for ladybugs, because if you have 4 of them, then you get 25 points.
Yeah, there was a surprising amount of strategy in this one. When I first saw it, I was like, ooh, cool, a kid's game, it looks cute, it's adorable, let's play this. And then it got a little cutthroat.
Yeah. And then there's a bunch of things you can do. You could go for the ladybugs. You could grab a whole bunch of butterflies and one of everything else. You could collect rug types and collect fireflies.
Yeah, so there's lots of different ways you can win. And then also what I thought was really unique, because it's just a set collection game at that mm-hmm. point, but the action I thought was really cool, was a really cool mechanic, because...
Yeah, the double use cards.
The next... Yeah, like if you're the second to last or the third to last person, you might not want that active player to have a really powerful action. So it might force you to pick up a card that maybe doesn't help you, but...
You don't have to deal with that other action.
Right. And maybe later, there's enough action types that you can get rid of it.
Yeah.
Put it on a wall or hand it to somebody. And so I thought that was just another cool way to think about which cards you want, not for the, rug or the bug, but for the act, to what the action was.
Yeah. So it's not just bugs on rugs. They also do things.
They're very active bugs.
They're active bugs on rugs. But they didn't put that in the name because it doesn't rhyme.
It doesn't rhyme.
So easy for kids. We played it. I mean, like you said, there is a surprising amount of strategy in this game, though it is pretty easy. You pick a bug, and then on your next turn, you pick a bug.
Yeah, did it look easy, Aiden?
Yeah. Yeah, it really looked easy. But like you said, you said there was lots of strategy, and you thought that it was going to be a really easy kids game, and then there was a cut in the throat.
Yeah,
cut in the throat.
So yeah, I mean, the rules are easy. There's once you understand kind of the icons, there's really no reading involved. So it's really just colors and shape recognition. So I mean, you could definitely play with preschool, kindergarten age kids. They're not going to destroy you with their in-depth strategy.
Yes,
but they'll be able to play. I also thought it was cool that it plays pretty much the same whether you're playing two players or whether you're playing five players.
It does, because it adds a whole bunch... it doesn't add cards. The end card is farther down in the deck.
Yeah, so exact same game, you'll just see less cards, which also makes the gameplay a little bit different, but still core.
Yeah, like it's probably easier to go for ladybugs with a higher player count.
Yeah, because you might not see enough ladybugs.
Though there's
still,
I think, 8 of them in the deck. I think we counted.
Yeah, but you might not get 4.
Yeah.
But you could get 2 mosquitoes and make a ladybug.
Also good. All right. So overall, I had a lot of fun with it. We played a couple times, and a lot of times we finished a game and they're like, let's play it again. We shuffle the cards, put the end card back in, and play again.
Yes. I've never been so happy to see bugs on my rugs. except when I'm playing bugs on rugs.
Especially cute bugs.
So, Bugs on Rugs by Kids Table Board Gaming. Thank you for watching Brian's Got Game. Please like us on our Facebook page, send us a tweet at Brian's Got Game, visit our webpage, brian'sgotgame.com, subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Brian, and this is my dad, and this is my sister. See you next time.